I have like a new vision for gifts now because I gift myself all the time, like throughout the year. I'd be like, treat yourself. So I treat myself all year round. Hey guys, welcome or welcome back to my channel. I am Iman and today I am back. Yes, it's been a little while with a video in the whole Christmas vibe. It's my Christmas 2021 wish list. This year it's a lot more conservative than last year. Last year I think I had 10 pieces. This time I have 5 plus a bonus one that's not really an item, but it's still a great gift. And of course, all as always, only from African designers. But the funny thing is, I just noticed I have no Nigerian brand on there, no Ghanaian brand neither. Like, I'm really staying with my roots. All the designers here are either from Côte d'Ivoire or from Senegal. I'm amazed. It's great because you know my love for Nigerian designers, but this time I chose great pieces, but none of them are from Nigeria. So let's see together. So first on my list is the Mon Eternel bag from the brand Illiquam, but the smaller size. And this bag, I really had a crush on it for over a year. I don't know, I really like the whole storytelling around it, first of all, but the shape is like super easy to wear. And they offer like a variety of textiles for your bag. Like, you can literally choose which textile you're using for your bag. And I really like that. And it's an Ivorian brand. And I don't think if I check, I maybe have one bag that's from an Ivorian designer right now, maybe two. But yeah, I really think this one is really an iconic bag. And I mentioned it actually last year in my bag, my iconic bag video. I'll put it up here if you want to check it out. But definitely this one is on my wishlist, and I know it's on a lot of people's wishlist around here because it's really, really stunning. Number two on my list, still from an Ivorian designer, and actually it's a brand that I had last year on my wishlist. It's fluid set from Ibrahim Fernandez. This time I wanted it in black and white because I know I'm going to wear it a lot, and I know I'm going to wear the pieces separate, so I feel like black and white will be the easiest. And actually, this set I had ordered it, I think, in May, but I think they had like a change with their system, and they, like, my order got lost somehow in the whole thing. So I'm going to get my hands on it finally, hopefully. Maybe not for Christmas Day, because I know that the order volume is huge for them, which is amazing because I think it's a great designer and he does a lot of great things. And the print he has really become like a showstopper. Like, you know when somebody's wearing one of his designs because of that print. And I think he's doing a fabulous job also in marketing. So altogether, I think this is a brand that really has to be pushed forward and encouraged by us as locals. Like, I would rather spend my money on an Ibrahim Fernandez design that rather than buying from, like, I'm not going to name names, but there are stores here, like international stores, international brands that I really do not care for. We don't have Zara. That's the only thing I wish we had, because I would definitely shop at Zara. But to me, yeah, this brand has the potential to be like premium African brand that works for people outside of Africa, because again, the designs are really like broad, and I think they suit people, different shapes, very, very much. Next, we're going to Senegal. So on my wish list at number three is the Malou jumpsuit from Tongo Studio. So Tongo is like such an amazing brand, such a successful brand that every time I want something, It sold out within minutes. It's incredible, and that's all great for Sarah because she's an amazing person. So she really deserves all of that success. And I'm really trying to get my hands on this. Like, I've been wanting, because I love the silhouette of it, and I love that despite the fact that it's like a larger silhouette at the bottom, it does not make you look huge. Like, it does not make you look out of place no matter the size you are. I really, really love it. And I know there's another version that's like a shorter version, like a romper type silhouette, but I prefer the jumpsuit silhouette because I'm a jumpsuit girl, and I know I'm not always yet comfortable with wearing things that are too short, but definitely as a jumpsuit, I know I will rock the heck out of it, and I cannot wait. I'm stalking the website whenever, and I've seen that they have a new colorway that's supposed to restock soon. So I'm keeping an eye on it, and I hope I can get my hands on it. Next, we have the Boubou dress from Adama Paris, Adama Studio. So I think this whole collection is amazing because she literally took a design that's a boubou, a kaftan, some people would say, and she turned it into very like trendy and modern pieces. So for the same design, you have like the shorter, you have shorter dresses, different styles, you have rompers, you have jumpsuits, and they even made a bomber out of them. And I saw the bomber actually in pictures from their runway show. I think it was in South Africa or in Nigeria at the Lagos Fashion Week. And I think that one looked amazing. Like, I know I mentioned it in my story on Instagram. It looked amazing. But for me at the moment, if I am to get one of these amazing design, it will be the shorter dress. Because I think it's a silhouette that's super interesting. And again, let's get back into focus here. In my wish list, I just talked about the jumpsuit. So I wouldn't take the jumpsuit because I don't want to. Not that I don't want to have two jumpsuits. Of course, I love jumpsuits, but I want variety in my purchases. So I would go with the shorter dress. I don't know yet which one, because I think there are at least like two or three designs. But in any case, I think they are made to order. They had a private sale in Abidjan last weekend, and I couldn't go. It's the second year in a row. I don't know if they do it on purpose, but it's the second year in a row where they do the private sale in Abidjan just at a moment where I'm not available for the weekend. Like, so sad. And number five on my list is the Sir skirt from the Senegalese brand again, Diarra Blue. I love this brand, Diarra Blue. I don't know what it is. Again, it's a mix of the prints, the silhouettes that are very feminine, but very well tailored. Like, I think I have at least like two or three items from the brand. And the first thing I bought was a dress, and I just really love it. And I wear it as often as I can because it's super comfortable. And I just love the fact that, I'll put a picture if I find one. It's like V-neck kind of dress. It's like a wrap dress. But what I really love is that at the V-neck, they made stitches so that it doesn't fall. It's not too deep. And I love that attention to details. Like, really, that was amazing to me. And it was well done on top of that. So yeah, I really like my dress. And now I want the skirt, because this skirt I've seen on their Instagram months ago. And it was already like, I was like, oh, this is looking cute. And it's the white and green, and it's like that Bottega green. You know what the Bottega green is, right? You know what it is. Anyways, yeah, it's like the white and Bottega green. And knowing that I'm not a big fan of white, I like that they mixed it with green, which is a color I feel like, not only is it super trendy, of course, Bottega green is like one of the colors of the year, although Pantone said the colors of the year are like purple and gray. I don't know why, but yeah, I really like the color, and I love a wrap moment, whether it's a wrap dress or wrap skirt, I'm here for it. And also for the wrap silhouette, Zara had so many of them, and I had a crush on the blue one, and it was like sold out like that, because you know Zara, when they have that one hot piece, you see it on the on social media, and it's because it's pretty much sold out at the moment you see it. So yeah, I couldn't get my hands on it, so I'm like, okay, better that I buy from an African brand, a woman-owned brand that I know has great quality. And I was kind of like, it was like at the back of my mind. And like about a month ago, I have a friend who came to Abidjan, so I took her around shopping. And Diarra Blue had a private sale at Couleur Concept. So I went with her and she bought that exact skirt. And then I saw it on her, I was like, bitch, this is bomb. Like, I have to get it. So I got it. It's on the way. So spoiler alert, I got it. And last, the little bonus I mentioned, it's something I talked about in my gifting guide on Instagram that I made 2 to 3 weeks ago, roughly maybe a month ago, still with African brands. It's shares. People buy shares, really. I'm not a professional, again, I'm not a professional at investing whatsoever, so, and I'm doing it in a way that is very careful because I'm not an expert, but even on my scale, I see the results. I see how great it is, and I find myself very interested in like researching and looking at new things, like what's hot, what's going on with the market, what's the next big thing, etc. It's really exciting. And I remember in finance class at university, it was not my favorite subject, but when we got into stocks, I was like, oh, this is interesting. And then we had even like a simulation kind of thing. It was an assignment and I got an A because my portfolio gained, I think we had to gain like 20% to get an A, and I got like 25%. In any case, in my real life portfolios now, I've been doing very well. So in Côte d'Ivoire here, we have the BRVM. It's like the regional share market. And I definitely think there are companies with good potential on there. So definitely do your research, check. It's super easy to open an account. Mine is at Bridge Securities, but I know pretty much any bank here in Abidjan has one of those. And if you're not in Abidjan, well, you can always buy, I believe, from your country. They should have access to shares here. Even when I was in France and I had a portfolio there, well, which I still do, but I always make sure that I request for them to put money on African markets, emerging markets, because that's where the future is at. See here, the future is African and female. That's it, that's the motto. So that's it for the video. I hope some of these are giving you ideas. You have 1 week left to shop, people. I'm almost done my Christmas shopping. Like, I have like 2 gifts left to do, and I already know what they are. I just have to go and actually buy them, which I think by Monday or Tuesday latest, it will be completed. I have all the gift wrapping ready. And yeah, I have like a new vision for gifts now, because I gift myself all the time, like throughout the year. I'd be like, treat yourself. So I treat myself all year round. So come Christmas, yeah, I want to treat myself on another level, but I'm not going like too crazy, which is why compared to last year, I downsized my wish list. Also, a reason why I downsized my wish list this year is that I'm going to put more money into redoing my room, because I'm not finished and I really want it to be finished in 2021. But I'm going to make sure I finish early 2022, and I will definitely do a tour, a room tour. I have great ideas that I'm working on with the people that do furniture here, that the guy that does all of this for me. I'm working on with him on something else, rather for my bed. And after that, I think I'll be pretty much done. I'm changing the drapes and the carpet, and then we Gucci. So thank you so much for watching. I hope you have an amazing Christmas. I hope I can post because I've been shooting a little vlog-ish type video. I hope I can post that next week. And except if I'm in the Harry Potter marathon that I do yearly. Yes. No, I will definitely post it before. Thank you so much for watching and have an amazing Christmas. Bye.